Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video where we are going to formulate the electric and magnetic microwave equations. So as of now, I am sure that you must be having a knowledge that microwaves are the electromagnetic waves having the frequency range 1 GHz to 300 GHz. The microwave sources, the various microwave devices based on the vacuum tubes and the semiconductor platforms have been introduced to you people into the second topic. Along with, we have seen the microwave setup bench. So microwave systems, you are well acquainted with various microwave applications we have discussed, and with the knowledge of how exactly the electron motion can be formulated in the presence of individually electric field, magnetic field and the electromagnetic field, we have seen. We have solved one problem based on to those concepts also into the previous video. Now, the microwave that shall be having a propagation inside various microwave components, if you take either the case of rectangular waveguide, isolator, if you take circulator, if you take or some another microwave components along with the horn antenna, the E plane T, H plane T. So the microwave will be governed by the equations that are the wave equations. So basically we shall be taking the help of Maxwell's equation. So let us have the derivation of microwave equations. So as we are going to derive the electric and magnetic microwave equations, as you know that microwave is the basic electromagnetic wave, so it has two fields, electric and magnetic. So I must recall that for electric field, we have the two vector quantities to denote, that is E bar, electric field intensity measured into volts per meter, then electric flux density, that is measured into coulombs per meter square. We have for magnetic, the field strength given by magnetic field intensity H bar. So this is equal to ampere per meter, and the magnetic flux density measured and denoted by B bar, measured into Weber per meter square or Tesla here. So the relationship between E, D, H and B is actually summarized by the Maxwell, and the Maxwell's equations into the first of all time domain I write here. So here we have del bar cross of E bar is equal to minus del B bar by del T. Next to that we have the equation del bar cross of H bar is equal to J bar plus del D bar by del T. Then del bar dot of D bar is equal to, here we have rho V, and del bar dot of B bar we have zero. So del bar is actually the del operator. It is basically vector into the nature. It is differential operator. So if you express this into the rectangular coordinate system, it is simply the partial derivatives with respect to the x along with the direction unit vectors here. So del x ax cap added with del y ay cap added with del z a z cap. So if you have the background from electromagnetic field theory, the del operator can be operated with either a scalar or a vector. So depending on the three vector operations we have, so that are gradient, divergence and curl. So here the cross denotes along with the del operator and vector. So this is curl operation. Curl operation is actually rotation of a vector with respect to the area traced here. So E denotes the electric field intensity. So when the rotation of electric field intensity into the time varying fields is carried on, we obtain it is equivalent to minus del del T. That means it is time derivative of magnetic flux density here. If the similar operation of having a rotation is carried on to the magnetic field intensity, del bar cross of H bar, it is actually produced or produces because of the J bar, that is the conduction current density cross sectional, it is actually added with another term, which is of course the current density. It is the time derivative of D bar. So D bar is the electric flux density. The dot operation along with the del operator for the electric flux density and magnetic flux density is actually the divergence operation. So divergence is actually the expansion or contraction of the vector field. So the four equations, the two equations are relating the rotation operation for the quantities here, EH, and the two equations expressing the divergence. So that is increase into the volume or decrease into the volume. So this is a set of Maxwell's equations. So if you see here onto the left hand side, if you are having this curl operation onto the E, so the time derivative with respect to B. So a component from the electric field, if you have changes with respect to the spatial operation, there will be a time change with respect to the component from the magnetic field. So E to B, so here you can see, then H to D. So H to D. So these are the relations of Maxwell's equation with which we come to know that if we have electromagnetic field, the electric and magnetic field goes hand in hand if you have the changes with respect to the time, and for del it is with respect to the space parameters with respect to the x, y and z if you opt rectangular coordinate system. So from this Maxwell's equation we are supposed to derive the microwave equations. Now for the first equation that I have shown you, that is del bar cross of E bar. So this was equal to minus del B bar upon del T. So for this particular equation, we take curl onto both the sides. So it is already del bar cross of E bar. So again, we take del bar cross of E bar on the left hand side. And here also we have to apply del bar cross of the RHS here. Now here for B bar, we shall be making a substitution here. The substitutions from the set of relations between D, E and H and B here. So we always know that D bar electric flux density can be obtained by having a relation of epsilon into E bar, where epsilon is permittivity of the medium. Along with, we know that B bar is equal to mu times H bar, where mu is the permeability of the medium. So mu is always measured into Henry per meter, epsilon is always measured into Farad per meter. So this background we have to take from electromagnetic field theory. So at the place of B bar, we shall be substituting mu H bar. So the above equation we can have in the modified form, del bar cross of del bar cross of E bar, we shall be writing. If you change to the frequency domain, so in that case it shall be taking minus j omega instead of del del t here, and this will be mu, and finally we will be left with h bar here. So this is the modification we have made here. So with the substitution of b is equal to mu into h, we shall be writing h here, but along with we have taken the curl operation onto the both the sides, so it will be actually del bar cross of h bar here. So del bar cross of h bar, we have already the formulation into the Maxwell's equation set. So from that set we can have the substitution in place of del bar cross of h bar. So by the next step we shall be writing it minus j omega mu inside the bracket sigma plus j omega epsilon. Here it will be E bar here. So the left hand side we keep as it is, del bar cross of E bar is equal to be obtained minus j omega mu in bracket sigma plus j omega epsilon times E bar here. Now this is the curl of curl. So in this particular place we can substitute with the vector identity, and according to that vector identity we put here minus del bar square of E bar added with, here we have del bar in bracket del bar dot of e bar here. So this is equal to minus j omega mu in bracket sigma plus j omega epsilon times capital E bar here. So here you see here there is no dot or cross in between this inside bracket and this del operator. So it means it is a gradient. So this is the gradient of divergence of E bar, gradient of divergence of E bar. So gradient is actually in only one direction. So it is the rate of change of a scalar quantity with respect to space here. And if you check the free space to be taken over here, so it will be a charge free there. So for that place, we shall be having the substitution of the second term onto the left hand side to be equal to zero here. So therefore, with the substitution in place of the constants here, we have the j into j, it will be actually j square, it is square root of minus 1 here. Omega is the angular frequency, mu is the permeability of the medium, epsilon is permittivity of the medium, and sigma is the conductivity of the medium. The three parameters, that is permeability, conductivity and epsilon, we can have all these constants substituted by another constant term. So that we shall be making here. So the substitution we can make, gamma is equal to square root of, here we make j omega mu in bracket sigma plus j omega epsilon. So as it is having the complex part and real part, we can have gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta. So from electromagnetic field theory, you can take a background that gamma is actually a propagation constant which is dependent onto the conductivity, permeability of the medium and permittivity of the medium, and it is constituted by the real part which is actually alpha, that gives us the information regarding the attenuation or the losses occurred here. So this is the attenuation constant, and beta is the phase shift constant. So with this particular substitution and substitution of the second term onto the left hand side to be equal to zero into the free space region, and not having the ideal gradient of divergence term, we obtained the next equation. So the equation, it will be del square E is equal to gamma square E. I don't put the bars over here, I take the magnitudes only. Actually the del square, it is the second order partial derivative operator, and it is basically a scalar here. So the equation here, that is del square E is equal to gamma square E, provided the substitution of gamma to be made. Gamma is the propagation constant. This is the wave equation or microwave equation for the electric field. Similarly, we can have the another equation by taking into the use the Maxwell's equation, the first set that we have given. So it will be del square H will be equal to gamma square H. So in this place also, the gamma will be having the same substitution here. Gamma is equal to under root j omega mu in the bracket sigma plus j omega epsilon, which is nothing but alpha plus j beta. So these are the two very important equations, the microwave equations for electric and magnetic field. For the frequency domain, the representations we can give in more details. So that equations are, so del square E, it will be equal to mu into sigma into del E by del T plus mu into E into del 2E divided by del T square. Next to that, we can have del square H computed as mu into sigma del H by del T plus mu into epsilon into del 2H divided by del T square. So the time domain form or the frequency domain form for the microwave equations can be given. By the next lecture, we shall be having a knowledge of pointing theorem with respect to the microwave propagation. So I hope you understand the fundamentals that we are concerned with the microwave engineering here. For more details, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.